Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory with another update. Before I start talking a little bit about the paint I'm using and some of the results I'm getting, wanted to tell you that we're down to the last like 10. I'm saving two for two people who've contacted me and said to please save them one. But we're down to the last 8 calendars, and once they're gone, they're gone. We are gonna work on the 2014 calendar, which we hope to have by the middle end of February. So, if you're suffering withdrawals, then you know you can get that. But 2013, we sold out, and we really appreciate all your support and all your wonderful contributions and help. It really does help keep things going. So I've been using, and I should have brought it over, I've been using the, with this build, I've been using a lot of Vallejo Air acrylics, and then a lot, some Golden and some ComArt, okay? Golden acrylics, ComArt, they are both released in kits, weathering kits. So a couple of you asked me where they were from or where you could get them, and I always send people to the same place when it comes to paints. Get them at least acrylics, not urethanes, because for urethanes I'd send you to Coast Airbrush, but for acrylics I send you over to one of my favorite places on the planet, Dick Blick Art Supplies in Chicago. Dick Blick. I love the sound of that. Dick Blick Art Supplies. They'll have it. They'll have the kits just like they have Pearl X, the whole kit. So it's a very professional, fast place, reasonably priced, and so you should be able to get your golden colors there and your ComArt colors. ComArt, which is part of Medea, which is part of Iwata, they released an amazing weathering kit that's been out for quite a while, and I've had it for at least 3 years now, 3-4 years, and use it all the time. I haven't even put a dent on it. I mean, a little bit goes a long ways when you're using acrylics, and I wanted to say this about painting with acrylics, just, kind of waxing poetic here. As long as you don't get your fingers in the paint, and this is true of any kind of paint, acrylic paint is very forgiving, use your hair dryer, right? I have it here. Use your hair dryer. And within seconds, your paint, your acrylic will harden, and it'll become really, really tough. So it could take a lot of punishment. It could take the punishment of salting. It could take the punishment of chipping, scratching with a toothpick or a very sharp tipped X-Acto blade, hobby knife, that kind of thing, a pin needle. A little piece of wire, whatever, and you could scratch, use a stiff bristled toothbrush, and you could scrub it under the sink. And the thing is to what begins to work, those of you who are already doing this and getting great results, is that the salt desaturates the paint as it lands, because the paint is wet, of course, and it rekindles its love affair with the salt, and then the salt sort of leaches out whatever chemicals it's got. So it sort of puts this kind of coating on the overall paint. And so when you go and remove the salt with water, cold water, and you use your toothbrush, the salt will often scratch the paint. The salt sort of disintegrates, obviously, and it leaves you this, you know, kind of mottled, splotchy, faded look to the paint. That's absolutely, it's highly addictive, highly addictive. That's where we're at, you know. Every time we do one of these builds, it's just revisiting a styrene addiction in its best form. So, but man, it's a lot of work, you know, it's a lot of work. But, the funny thing about it is that, you know, a big guy like me, can use getting up quite often. So the trips to get the airbrushes cleaned, it's back and forth. And so, you know, 24, you know, 36, 48, 72 hours later, after 2-3 days of constantly painting every single part, weathering everything, adding the details, then, you know, by the time you get to final assembly, you look at it and you go, man, I should leave it alone. It looks great, and I'm so proud. But of course, there's, you know, that's just the beginning, because then you have to come back in with the washes, with the pigments, and continue weathering and just adding those tiny little details that's gonna make the model pop, you know, pop. So I'm really happy with the way this thing is turning out. So, you know, get your paints, your paint collection is going to grow just like your kit collection is going to grow, but understandably so, your paint collection is probably going to grow faster than your kit collection. I've had paint here that's been here for the last 8-10 years. Don't be afraid to keep the paint around. You know, if it turns bad on you, you'll know it. And so you toss it out and continue. Acrylics, if they're well sealed, will last. Just make sure you get a little pellet in there to shake it up. I still have all of my House of Color paints. Everything is holding steady until you know I use it again. And so I don't mind, you know. And I have paint that all I have to do is shake it. And then some bottles don't even have the pellet. But I just have, you know, one of the things that I like to do with acrylics in particular is just keep changing the colors, and what I would call what a lot of people call modulating the color, which is coming up with gradients, you know, different hues, all of that good stuff, just to, because it's one color, it's just not one color, you know, when you're working with weathering and with the salt. You know, black is not just black. Black has, and especially on a rat rod, you know, when you look, it's got all kinds of colors in there. You know, some blue, some grays, some green, orange, the rust colors. You know, so there's a lot of possibility in terms of how it's going to end up looking. So enjoy the journey. You know, enjoy the journey. Go with it. Don't get frustrated. When you end up with a model, then you can assess it and say, well, you know what, I really like this model, or no, I don't like this model. Either way, though, you will have learned something valuable, and that's going to make you into a much better model builder for the next time. And the next time is you know, it's your own individual journey in terms of your addiction. How often do you build your models, and what are you looking for, you know? Some people collect particular vehicles. I just build my imagination. That's the collection. My model collection at the end is going to be a reflection of those things that possessed me at the time and really drove my imagination towards some sort of idea. And that's what it is. And so that's my collection. Some people do racing vehicles. Some people do, factory stock. You know, it's what gets you going as a builder. So anyway, I've said too much. Until next time, my friends, Dr. Cranky here with another Cranky Show. Stay tuned in for more. And remember, visit the laboratory. Go on over and help support our efforts to get this newsletter, the Lab Notes magazine, going. So we appreciate your support and we appreciate your love. All right, until next time, Cranky Heads, be well.